Lois, this pumpkin pie looks delightful.
Hey, Kevin, can I see your purple heart? Because I never actually seen one. One time, this homeless guy showed me his purple head, but looking back, I'm not so sure that that was a military thing.
I didn't want that stupid medal. You know what I did with it? I threw it back over the White House fence.
Wait a minute. I thought you said you flew straight home from Kuwait after you woke from your coma. When did you throw your medal over the White House fence?
No, I told you. I flew to D.C., ditched the medals, and flew home.
I guess that was just his dirty hobo penis, huh?
Kevin, why would you want to get rid of your war medals like that?
Because it was a stupid war, you know? All it did was put me in a coma and kill one of my bunkmates and cripple the other one for life.
Wait a minute. Now, I thought earlier you said that both of your bunkmates were killed. Now you're saying only one of them was?
But I just want you guys to know I barely even stared at that penis for an hour.
What? Come on, Dad. Whatever. Hey, why is it so hot in here? It's too hot in here.
Wait a minute. An Ed Hardy t-shirt? That particular strain of douchebag didn't arise until 2007 while you were supposedly in your coma.
Look, get off my case, Dad. What do you want from me?
The truth.
Fine. Here's the truth. I was never in any coma, okay? I bailed. I faked my death and went AWOL.
I faked my own death once. No dentist appointment for this guy.
So, there it is. I'm not a war hero. I abandoned my platoon. So now what do we do?
Me? Am I supposed to say something?
Kevin, you're under arrest for the crime of desertion.
Oh my, maybe it's time for us girls to hit the powder room.
You may use the yard.
So, you were lying to us this whole time? You weren't really injured in Iraq?
First Pat Tillman lies about how he died, and now you?
Kevin, I don't understand.
There's nothing to understand. Our son is a deserter. Come on, Kevin, I'm taking you to jail.
Joe, wait!
Not now, Bonnie.
Joe, you can't!
Bonnie, we'll discuss this later!
Joe! You're not taking my son anywhere!
Damn it, you guys are ruining Thanksgiving! And it's my second favorite holiday, right after pretend not to notice people's race day. Hey, you seen Reggie around?
Which one is Reggie?
Oh, today he's wearing yellow pants, yellow shirt, yellow hat, yellow shoes. He's got a gold tooth, diamond earring. He's got that big necklace with a dollar sign on it. He's always grabbing his crotch when he's telling a story, like the one about when he found out his mother is really his grandmother.
Could you be more specific?
Let's see. He always wears cheap cologne, drives a Mercury Cougar with a crown on the dashboard, never pays his alimony. He's extremely cut for a guy who never works out. Oh, there he is. Thanks anyway. Hey, Reggie!
Look, maybe we should just let Kevin explain why he did what he did.
At first, I believed in the cause. But then I saw what we were doing to the people of Iraq. Innocent people. There was one that I'll never forget. He was a little Iraqi street kid. I'd befriended him a few months earlier. Couldn't have been more than 12 years old. I taught him how to crack wise American style.
I guess that store is having a fire sale.
I tell you, that kid was strong-headed for his age. Smart, but innocent. And then one day, there was a firefight. We bring in the civilian who got killed in the crossfire. I pull back the sheet, and who is it? Not the kid, but like the kid's dad's, like, co-worker's neighbor. He was 74, and he had actually tried to rape someone. But just looking down at his dead face, and knowing that he lived near someone who worked with the dad of the kid whose name I never found out, I lost all hope. That's when I knew I had to get out of Iraq. I just had to wait for my chance.
I call the white meat.
I call the dark meat.
I call the cell phone duct tape to the side.
No!
Somehow I'd been spared that Thanksgiving, but I can't say the same for my bunkmates. There were bits and pieces of them everywhere. I knew the army would never be able to identify who was who, so that was my chance to disappear. So I left.
How could you do that? Coward!
Traitor! If you think that I'm gonna masturbate after this tonight, you're right!
We don't have to sit here and listen to this! Come on, Kevin, let's get out of here!
Nice try, Skank.
Worth a shot.